Welcome home. Hey everybody, how are we? Is that only one voice you hear? Tis. For the first time ever, we have a solo episode of Welcome Home. As you homies may know, Dolan is on a hiatus from the show right now. So that's causing us to adapt and change in different ways. Episode 12, here we are. Solo pod, it's just Griff. So we've gotten some feedback in the past that apparently some people find Dolan's voice very soothing. We've also gotten some feedback that some people find my voice more soothing. If you're the latter, then you're in luck. If you're the former, bear with me, I suppose. But yeah, here we are. Solo welcome home. Empty house, if you will. Where all my homies at. For all my new listeners, welcome home. We're happy to have you here. Thanks for joining us. Make sure to follow us on Instagram and Twitter at Welcome Home Pods. You follow us there for episode drops, giveaways, just general stuff that's going on with the show. We'd also really appreciate if when you see an episode drop, repost it. Help us out a little bit. If you're a fan of Welcome Home, we need you to do your part. Repost that shit. To all my returning listeners, welcome home, homies. How are you guys? I missed you. Thanks for coming back. You guys are some real ones. Thank you for bearing with me here. And, you know, going forward, we're just going to do what we can until Dolan's ready to come back. But stick around for the end of the episode. Got a little Dolan send-off for you. If you guys enjoy your time here with the Welcome Home podcast, feel free to leave us 5 stars. Nice written review. We'd really appreciate that. If you're a super fan of the Welcome Home podcast, guess what? Right in the episode description is a link to our Patreon. Supporting us through Patreon is going to get you a little bit more of a behind-the-scenes look into not only the Welcome Home podcast, but 812 Media Productions as a company. Subscribing to the avid Welcome Home listener is going to get you access to Welcome Home After Party, which is a video podcast of Welcome Home. It's just a little bit of after-the-show stuff, kind of breaking it down. A little more informal, laid-back kind of video podcast for you guys to get a little more personal and familiar. Supporting the higher tiers on our Patreon is also going to get you the opportunity to get some merch. Now, this shit's really cool. And I'd love to tell you guys, hey, just go on Patreon. There's a store right there. You can buy whatever. I wish. It's not really the case. If you're a fan of Welcome Home or you'd like to show your support for 812 Media Productions, subscribing to one of the merch tiers will require 3 months of support. Not my rule. Patreons. The merch actually comes directly from them, so like they don't bill me for it. Showing your support for us is going to really help us continue to grow and evolve as a show and a company and continue to bring you guys great content that you love and get better as we go. We really want to take this to a very big level, and we're going to get there through support from you guys. One day we're going to have a store where you can just go and purchase our merch. But we're going to get there through the support from fans like you guys. We really appreciate all the support that we get, and we thank you. Also, if you enjoy just listening to me, or, you know, sometimes listening to me with a guest, check out 812 Gaming. Go on twitch.tv/812gaming. You'll be able to find us there, streaming some stuff like some Mario. Everybody loves Mario, right? Streaming some Breath of the Wild, one of the greatest games ever, and a bunch of other stuff. Definitely go check us out there and spread the word. 812 Gaming, you hear me? All right, guys, well, let's just dive right into it. Solo pod, like I mentioned, it's just me, Griff. Just chilling, just hanging out. I don't know how the fuck this is gonna go. This is different, you know, and I appreciate you guys bearing with me here. Who knows? Maybe you'll enjoy it. Maybe we've struck gold. I don't know. But it's a different version of Welcome Home for sure. How you guys doing? How's your week been? In the past couple weeks, I've just, as always, continued to put in work on the show like I do. Takes a lot of elbow grease. It's a product that I've been happy with so far and seems a lot of people enjoy. Like I said, we're just continuing to grow and evolve and try to figure it out. We're hoping Dolan will be back soon. He's a fantastic co-host. You're going to get to meet some new people too as we go along here, which is exciting for everybody, I guess, right? Like, who doesn't like meeting new people? I mean, I don't really like meeting new people, but, you know, there is a certain thrill to it, isn't there? You know, sometimes you come across someone, you meet someone for the first time, you're like, oh, man, this friendship seems like it could be really cool. Meeting a new person It's just almost open-ended. I mean, yeah, for sure, there's a lot of times you meet somebody and already have preconceived notions from this, that, or the other thing. That's up to you as an individual to be able to ignore that and make a judgment for yourself. When you meet somebody new, there's just a lot of potential. You could never see them again. You could see them for the rest of your life. It really is just an opportunity. Like, I mean, any opportunity, obviously, you want to make the most of. But meeting new people is a potential opportunity to change your life in some way that you may not even be able to foresee. And that's the thing. I'm a pretty closed off person. It's hard for me to open up and accept new people in my life. But sometimes taking that leap of faith, we've talked a couple times over the course of the podcast over various topics about just taking a leap of faith in a sense. But when you meet somebody new, it's a chance to change your life. And yeah, 98.7%, 99% of people you meet aren't going to matter in the long run. It's that small percent that does. But every time you meet a new person could be a potential opportunity to include that person in that small percent. You never know. That actually is kind of like my friendship with Dolan. We may have mentioned before, maybe early on, that we've been friends for 13 years. And we actually became friends because throughout middle school, we always had the same, they were called unified arts. So it's like wood shop, cooking, art, music, like all that kind of stuff. We would always be in the same unified arts. And it was just a friendship that always stuck. Again, that's 10-year-old Griff meeting somebody new. But 10-year-old Griff opening himself up to somebody new allowed, you know, a chance to add to that small percentage in my life. Some of my other friends that I've met through sheer chance, I don't know. Something to think about. Especially like if you're like me and you're closed off, meeting new people is not a bad thing. You gotta look at each opportunity individually. And, you know, you gotta act accordingly, obviously. And everybody's gonna act differently. They're gonna act however they act. But I guess the main point here that I'm trying to make as I'm trying to figure out this pod, make the most of your opportunities. Be open-minded. Follow your instinct. Do what you think is right. Nobody knows you better than yourself. And that's a damn fact. All right. Well, that was a little cold open, maybe you want to call it something. How about we get into some Reddit? I could get into some Reddit. Reddit's always good. All right, everybody. It's time for the Reddit referral. Let's start with this one here. Me and my buddy stole hundreds of dollars worth of books in fifth grade from the book fair during lunch. Me and my buddy in fifth grade were some badass little punks, man. Y'all remember the book fairs at school, right? All those cool-looking books that you've always wanted would all just be sitting there, waiting to be bought. But we didn't buy them. The book fair was set up in the cafeteria. So during lunch, we would walk around looking at books, and we would pick out the book that we were going to steal. But we would just stand there and look at it. We would wait until the bell rang for everybody to leave the cafeteria, because when the bell rings, all hell breaks loose. Hundreds of little kids go scrambling, making it almost pathetically easy to shove a book up our shirts and go running off. Combined, my buddy and I had stolen around 20 books. On the very last day of the book fair, I got caught trying to steal the brand new Diary of a Wimpy Kid book. I got kicked out of school for 5 days, and my mom beat the shit out of me every single one of those days. She even threw away my new Xbox 360. But hey, thieves get what they deserve, I guess. I haven't stolen anything since. Kids, don't steal. It's not worth getting a bell to the ass. Well, Jesus. There's a couple things to break down here. First off, I wonder what Diary of a Wimpy Kid book it was. I used to be into the Diary of a Wimpy Kid books. Who wasn't, really? I don't think I ever came across somebody and they were like, Diary of a Wimpy Kid, what the fuck? Like, no, I'm not reading that. It's a good John. I think I only ever made it up to maybe the fourth book, maybe the fifth, I don't know. But that was a solid book series. It was a solid couple of movies, too. I enjoyed the Diary of a Wimpy Kid movies. I haven't seen the reboot one that they did, but the older ones, the original ones, I saw those. Secondly, kicked out of school for 5 days. That makes sense. Your mom beat the shit out of you every single one of those days. That's not great. You hate to hear that. I don't know what to say there. It's a bad John. I'm sorry to hear that. Throwing away your new Xbox 360, though. That's drawn. She definitely, like if it was new, she definitely just spent $300, $200, $250, whatever it was when she bought it. She just spent that. And then she's like, no, fuck you. Like, didn't take it away from you. Threw it out. That's ridiculous. I mean, hopefully it led you to get off the Xbox and get on the PlayStation, but I suppose that's besides the point. Getting the belt to the ass, that can't feel good. But yeah, that all sounds about right, to be honest. That makes sense. You were punished accordingly, but, you know, I'm not gonna knock the hustle, I suppose. It's a good idea, and it was working until it didn't.
I actually, one time in elementary school, we had a book fair, and some kid just randomly gave me $20 for some reason. And I know what this sounds like. This probably just sounds like I stole his $20. I promise you, for some reason, this kid decided to give me his $20. So that day I went to the book fair and I made out like a bandit. I got all the good shit. Cause not only did I have his $20, but I think I probably had like $20, $25 that I was sent into school with for the book fair. So I was fucking balling that. You'd have that dumbass, I don't know, fucking meeting or whatever, where you go and take a tour and see what they have. Okay, like, unnecessary. I can just go see myself. But there was like a certain fun to walking around and seeing all the different stuff they had, because they did have some cool shit. And you could definitely find something somewhere that would pique your interest. So shout out book fairs, man. Everybody should go read a book. I can't necessarily say I read a lot of books, but once in a while I like to try to read. My readings, it comes and goes, but I can put sentences together. All right, let's do this one here. I used church offering money to buy candy and donuts as a kid. When I was a kid, my parents took my siblings and I to church with them each week, and we stayed for all three services, as my parents volunteered for two of the three services. Volunteer first, watch second, volunteer third. So we were there for several hours each Sunday. Us kids would help them during the first service and then go to Sunday school classes the remaining two. In Sunday school, they would teach us kids the importance of giving tithes? I'm not sure what this word is. T-I-T-H-E-S? Titties? I don't know. Like I said, my reading comes and goes. Yeah, let's go with titties. They would teach us kids the importance of giving titties and offerings. That's just not right. To help those in need. So my mom would give each of us kids $2 to give for offering each week. By the time I reached second grade, my friend and I discovered the vending machine and soda machine in the stairwell down the hall from our classroom. We would use our offering money to buy either chips, candy, and a soda, back when everything in the machines was under a dollar. Or we would go to the breakfast place on the opposite side of the church and get a donut and orange juice. If we ever had change, that's what we would donate instead. This went on for years until extenuating circumstances caused my parents to stop volunteering at the church and just attend one sermon a week.
Well, again, I'm not going to knock the hustle here. I mean, a donut and an orange juice sounds fucking delicious. I don't know how anyone could possibly blame you for that. And yeah, I mean, if you got change and you're donating that, you're cool. Yeah, I mean, you can't turn down a donut. I wonder what my fucking favorite kind of donut is, man. That'd be a great question. Well, that'll be coming soon. I'll add that to the question vault. Tune into future episodes to find out the answer. Yeah, man, this is smart. This is a good idea. You did the right thing. What can I say? I'm actually a little more concerned with the extenuating circumstances causing your parents to stop volunteering and just attending the one sermon a week. Was the church like, hey, you guys are really overdoing it? Like, you need to stop? This isn't healthy? Fucking something. Because, like, you can still attend the one sermon a week, but they're just like, no, you can't volunteer. Also, extenuating circumstances, does that mean just not giving up your whole Sunday? Saying, oh, hey, football's on? Because that makes sense. But, yeah, it's a good kid. Proud of you. All right, I'm going to do a wrap on the Reddit referral with that. Like I said, I'm just trying to figure it out, taking it one step at a time. But hey, let's get into some questions, huh? Here's a good one that there's some fundamental disagreements over. Sleeping with socks on or off? Now, again, I don't have a co-host here with me to offer a counterpoint, but for me personally, my feet for some reason get like fucking hot. I don't know how to properly describe it. It would be easier to understand if you were to just like kind of feel my feet when they're acting like that. But that's a whole separate thing. And it only ever happens at night. Obviously, there's got to be some kind of correlation, but it's fucking weird, man. It's uncomfortable. Like, I just wish a lot of the times I could have just a fucking bucket of ice and just put my goddamn feet in it. And I feel like my feet would melt the bucket. Well, not the bucket, but like the ice in the bucket. That's how fucking hot these things are, man. It's horrible. I hate it. That's besides the point. That's a whole other issue. But it feeds into, yeah, no, socks off. I like when I sleep, I suppose, in a sense, like proper ventilation to my extremities to properly cool my body throughout, in a sense, while still using a cover. If you could follow that, I know there's like a couple twists and turns there. So, for example, let me just sound it out for you here. If you were lost asleep with my feet sticking out from under the covers, usually, because that allows the fan or the cool air or whatever to hit my feet
therefore allowing it to circulate throughout my body and cool my body. Same with my arms. Sometimes I sleep with just one arm out, tuck one away, but I like to keep my body very cool. I like to be cool when I sleep. I don't like to be fucking hot. I don't like to be all bundled up and shit. Well, I do sometimes, but only when the goddamn room is cold. I just like to sleep in a cold environment. I'm not a fucking vampire or anything like that. I don't even know if that's a thing vampires do, but I like to sleep in the cold. Also, I don't know how people can sleep with socks on, to be honest. Again, my perspective's out of whack because my fucking feet just get hot, so they're already hot in the goddamn socks. Can't imagine sleeping with them on. Short answer, well, we've already gotten the long answer, but I sleep with my socks off.
All right, here's an interesting one. After you shower, do you sit in your towel for a while or get changed right away?
For me, it depends. I've done both. Honestly, don't take this the wrong way, but it depends how wet I am. Nowadays, usually when I get out the shower, I got the towel right there waiting for me. Get out on the bath mat and I just completely dry my body so I'm ready to get changed. But sometimes, if I'm walking back to my room in the towel, I get back in there. Got nothing to do right away. Yeah, like I won't lay around in my towel per se. I'll lay on my towel, which might be worse. Like, I'll fucking, because I don't want to lay in my bed wet and naked, I guess. But I guess in my head, I deem it okay to fucking, like, spread out the towel and lay on the towel. It still gets the bed wet. I don't know. It's just what I do. So I've done both, but overall, depends on the day. It depends on the situation. You can't give a broad answer when you could do either on any given day, really. The main time, I would say, when I did the lay in bed on the towel thing was like back when I was in school. Wake up early in the morning, make sure you're showered, got a couple extra minutes to lay around, don't get dressed right away. Nowadays, like I said, I usually dry off completely when I step out the shower and I'm ready to just throw on my clothes for the day. So in general, that would be my answer, but I can see both sides of the coin. I'm not about just laying in the towel, just to be laying in the towel, just to be lazy, like, oh, you know. But you got a couple extra minutes, like, actually have a couple extra minutes. You got nowhere to be, you don't need to be dressed right at that second. Sure, why not? All right, last question for us here. Girls with short hair or long hair? Straight or curly? So, right off the bat, I'll tell you, I prefer girls with long hair. But girls with short hair, depending on the style, depending on how they wear it, can be very attractive, very beautiful, for sure. Not necessarily my preference, like I said, but there's definitely certain ways to have a shorter hairstyle and do it very well. I prefer longer hair. Straight versus curly. I do like both. Honestly, 50-50, but actually, I think maybe I prefer curly, honestly, a little bit. I like both. There's nothing wrong with straight hair. But curly hair just looks very pretty. There's a reason girls usually be curling their hair before they go out to like a nice dinner or somewhere to be. They like to curl their hair. It's because it looks very nice. And I agree. So I'm going to give that the slight edge and go with curly. So answer on a whole, long curly hair. All right. And that's going to bring an end to the first part of our podcast. How you guys doing? You hanging in there? Again, I appreciate you sticking with me for the solo welcome home episode here. Episode 12, yet another milestone, solo episode. What we're going to talk about on the second part of the podcast is I'm going to start to just a little bit because this is definitely a topic of conversation I want to bring up again in the future, especially when Dolan gets back on, is the multiverse. And it's the topic that I had been planning to discuss with Steve on tonight's episode because he had brought it up in the car to me a few weeks back and I could see it was about to spark sort of an interesting conversation, I suppose. And I said, nope, put a pin in it. Let's save it for the pod. But here we are now. So I'm going to start to dive in and talk about that for a little bit here to bring home the solo welcome home. So, the multiverse. There's a couple different trains of thought, a couple different ways of thinking about the multiverse as far as what it is, what it means, what it can do, all that. For the sake of discussing it here, I'm going to discuss it in terms of my interpretation, which is the idea that every possibility happens
in some parallel universe. So there's this universe where the podcast is called Welcome Home. There's another universe where the podcast is called Welcome Back Home. There's another universe where the podcast is called Back at Home. You know, you get what I'm saying? Like, and it's with every single possibility. There's a universe where every single possibility takes place. So it's basically infinite. This was a really interesting idea to me a few years back, in particularly because I experienced a dream, as people do, right? But the dream felt so real to me that when I woke up, I felt as though there was no way I wasn't seeing into a parallel universe. And I know what you're saying. I know what you're thinking. Oh, lucid dream. No, it wasn't a fucking lucid dream. And I'm willing to bet that about 99% of people who say they've lucid dreamed haven't fucking lucid dreamed. I haven't. You know, and I'm not saying because I haven't, that means nobody else has. Like, I'm just saying I haven't been able to accomplish it. I don't believe that every other person saying that, yeah, oh, I lucid dream. No, I don't think you do. I think you're lying. Or I think you're just misinterpreting what a lucid dream is. Or maybe I am. I don't know. That's a topic of conversation for a different time. That's a different podcast for you. Getting off track. Getting back on track. So I experienced this dream. It feels so real to me. I wake up the next day. I spend hours watching different documentaries, different videos of multiverse theory, parallel universes, X, Y, and Z, all that, right? I get very into it. But obviously, I haven't been able to fucking just open up a fucking portal to a parallel universe. I'm not Rick Sanchez, right? Rick and Morty. But yeah, I mean, it's a crazy thought because every possible outcome of a possibility exists somewhere in the multiverse, creating countless ripple effects throughout that world, if you will. But it makes you think, what is this universe? What is this timeline that I'm living in? What is this? And I'm not trying to get into what is life, because honestly, that would probably be a good let's talk about episode. That one would be long as fuck. And I promise you, we're not going to have an answer for you. But what universe am I living in that these are the outcomes that happened? Out of all the possibilities, every outcome has led me to here. And there's a parallel universe next door that one outcome could change. One singular outcome. Not necessarily two or three or 10, just one outcome could change. That's a whole separate universe. That's a parallel universe. The whole life could be identical besides one thing. But how does that one thing change and shape and impact that person in that life? What happens with that one thing? What does that one thing mean? What does that one thing do? What universe is this that one thing happened here that made this life what it is? It's crazy. And you know, do I sit here as a full believer, like, oh yeah, no, there's parallel universes everywhere? No, I can't say that, and I won't. But what I love about it is, again, I didn't even fucking plan this. This just happened naturally. Just the possibilities that could lead to. Like I was saying earlier, you meet somebody new. That encounter, that meet, has the possibility to impact the rest of your life. You befriending that one person creates this timeline that changes your life. Yeah, I mean, there's a parallel universe where I'll be the president, and that would require a lot of fucking changes. But the idea of the parallel universe, the multiverse, can open up just your mind. You just sit back and you think about your life, like, hey man, fuck, what can I make of myself? Well, fuck, make this that timeline, make this that universe, make this the one that you make the decision, you make the change. The possible outcome that you go with is the one that's going to change your life and impact you forever and beyond. Because don't get me wrong, you are your own worst enemy, but you're also your greatest ally and weapon. Don't forget that. Like Dolan always tells you guys, believe in yourself. You have the power to make your life whatever you want. You have the power to take this universe in the entire multiverse and make the change, make the decision, choose the outcome. That's going to change your life. Never shy away from opportunities, because you never know what endless possibilities those opportunities could lead to. It's crazy, man.
I would definitely recommend going to YouTube, type in, you know, multiverse theory or parallel universes or what have you. Just watch a couple videos, find a couple that look reputable, and just take some time and check it out, because it's really cool and it can really open your mind to a lot of things. Definitely recommend it. That's the Griff certified recommendation. Sometimes it's food, sometimes it's whatever. Suppose this week it's multiverse theory. My certified recommendation, go check out some stuff on the multiverse theory. It's fascinating. It's really cool. And whether you choose to believe it or not is besides the point. It's a theory. So look at it as such and take the theory, the idea of these parallel universes, and just think of how amazing that is, that there is a universe for every possible outcome. Some cool shit. Check it out. And I think I'm actually going to cap it there. Like I said, I just wanted to dip my toe in the water, if you will, as far as the multiverse goes, because that's a very expansive topic that I would definitely like to discuss with a co-host. And I'm particularly intrigued, of course, by Dolan's thoughts on it. So I'm sure that'll be a great episode for when he gets back from hiatus. That's going to bring a close to episode 12 of Welcome Home, the solo episode. Thank you guys so much for sticking with me through this. I appreciate it so much. You guys are the best. You're really holding it down. I thank you so much for your support. When episode drops get posted, I want to see you guys reposting that shit. Repost it in your stories. Tag at Welcome Home Pods. We need your help spreading it. We need your help growing. Let's do this together. You guys are our homies. I'm calling on you guys. And if you'd like to show more support for the Welcome Home podcast, there's a link to our Patreon right in the episode description. Supporting us through Patreon is going to get you exclusive behind-the-scenes access to things with not only the Welcome Home podcast, but also 812 Media Productions as a company. Supporting us is going to help us continue to grow and evolve for you guys, continue to develop, get better, continue to bring you guys great content that you love, and just keep growing into an amazing podcast for y'all. Supporting us through Patreon will also get you the opportunity to acquire some merch. So definitely check that out. It's some pretty cool stuff. And again, we'd really appreciate the support. We thank you for all the support we get. It all means very much. Stick with it, guys. Thanks. If you enjoyed your time here with Welcome Home, make sure to leave us 5 stars, nice written review. And like I said, follow us on Instagram and Twitter at Welcome Home Pods. That way you can keep up to date with episode drops, giveaways, things we got going on, whatever. The best way to stay up to date with Welcome Home. And don't forget to subscribe on your podcast platform of choice, whether that be Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google Podcasts, whatever. Subscribe so you can have access to episodes as soon as I publish them. If there's any episodes you haven't caught up with on Welcome Home, be sure to go back and check those out too. There's some really great content there, a lot of laughs, a lot of good stuff. Be sure to go back and listen and catch up if you haven't. And don't forget, like I said, if you enjoyed just listening to me here, maybe you want to check out 812 Gaming. Go to twitch.tv/812gaming. You can check me out playing some stuff like Mario, Breath of the Wild, bunch of fucking PS4 stuff, I got so many games to play. We got a lot of great content coming for you there. You're definitely going to want to check that out. It's going to be really cool. And it's our first expansion. And we got more stuff coming for you guys in the near future. Make sure you are following us to stay up to date. And make sure you're tuning in so you know when new stuff is coming, because we got some new stuff coming. Before I sign off here, as promised, here's Dolan.
Hey guys, it's Dolan here. Just here to remind you guys, you can always do whatever you put your mind to. Don't ever let anybody discourage you, and don't take a bad situation and make it worse. Always try to find the bright side and the positive in things. It'll make anything you're going through a lot easier to deal with. Trust me. Love you guys. Welcome home.
Thanks, bud. We love and we miss you here on Welcome Home, and we can't wait for you to be back. Got a lot of stuff to talk about, pal. All right, well, again, I want to thank you guys for sticking with me for the solo episode of Welcome Home. And there's probably going to be more solo episodes coming in the future, so something to get used to. Hopefully we'll get better. Hopefully you don't hate it. But thanks for sticking with me. Thanks for supporting. Thanks for everything. You guys are the best. You're the homies. Thank you. Thanks, everybody, for listening. Welcome home.
This episode has been brought to you by 812 Media Productions.